for watching my video and for subscribing to my YouTube channel. If you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, please click the subscribe button. We're at the Laurel, Maryland VW dealership. My VW Tiguan finally broke, so I'm gonna answer the question: is the VW Tiguan expensive to repair? That's right. I made a video the last time answering the question whether the maintenance of the VW Tiguan, like oil change, like, you know, like fluid change and all that stuff, is expensive. Actually, it's not the maintenance part, but since the car comes with turbo, that's right, I don't like cars that come with turbocharger, because what, turbocharger can go bad. And before I took the car to the dealership, I checked the price of a brand new turbocharger at the ECS tuning. I think the price was between 1,500 to 1,900. So that's just the part alone, okay? Just for brand new turbo. And then for, that's not including the labor, just the turbo alone. So finally, at, go ahead, Brenna, at 57,753 miles, the turbocharger finally went bad. And this is the, can you show where the dealership is in the back? So yeah, we're at the service center. So, and anyway, this is, okay, let's answer the question. Is VW Tiguan expensive to repair? I think you're gonna be really shocked. I'm so glad that I bought the $1,200 extended warranty. It was for 2 years of ownership. The car, because I bought it used, it's 2013. It's not a new car. It's right now it's 2018. So it's a 5-year-old car and it's not new anymore. The turbo finally went bad. And then while they did the diagnostic, I think if you see my video, the last time when I did my transmission fluid, there was a leak in the bottom of the car. Apparently, the water pump went bad too at 53,000 miles. Okay, so before you buy VW Tiguan, keep this in mind. Should you get extended warranty? I said yes. If you buy it used, please get extended warranty, because the repair is not cheap. The parts are expensive, like I said. Even if you buy it from what do you call that, OEM, or from what do you call that, out of the market, aftermarket parts, the turbo costs $1,500 to $1,900. It's expensive part. And the water pump is not so bad. And then okay, this is what happened today. I spent, okay, without the extended warranty, I was supposed to spend, check this out, $4,320.02. So that's without the warranty. And with the safeguard warranty that I purchased, what happened? Safeguard called me, well, we're gonna cover everything. And then I said, but VW said, oh, we have to charge you like $1,500, right, to repair the turbo, you know, for the labor and the turbo parts. And I said, why you guys are telling me the two different things? And then after digging a little bit further, I learned that safeguard warranty was trying to convince the VW dealership to put a used turbo from another car. It's not even refurbished, okay, a used turbo. And the VW said, no, we're not gonna put a used turbo on the customer. So okay, fine. And then yeah, so be careful with extended warranty. Sometimes they're trying to what, to do like cheap work on your car so they don't have to pay too much. So, but still, what happened, what they did today is they changed the bunch of parts right here. Here we go. The turbo kit comes with like all the gasket, the clamp, washer, stud, nut, X-Man turbo. See, the turbo itself, like 1,310. This is just turbo, okay, not including the labor. And then the water pump is $297. Oh, another thing that went bad while they did, it was the, all this part right here. Let me see where's, oh, right here, no, right here, down here, please. Oh, the speed sensor too went bad. So anyway, they did a lot of work today. Without the extended warranty, I was supposed to pay $4,320 and what, 2 cents. But with the warranty pay 2,631.33. But I have to pay 1,688.69. Is it expensive? Well, if you don't have extended warranty, it will be a costly repair. So just a heads up, if you buy a VW Tiguan used, make sure you got the what? Extended warranty, because today, with all this major work, actually it's 4 or 5 year old car is not that bad. I remember when I have, some of you will say Toyota is cheaper. No, Toyota wasn't cheaper. I had to pay actually 1,500 to repair my Toyota Tercel, okay? It wasn't even luxury car, it was a Toyota Tercel. I had to spend 1,500 to change the clutch and the radiator. It's just parts and labor. Even Toyota itself is expensive. And keep this in mind, when you have an old car, like 5-year-old car, it may need repair. Is it expensive? Well, it's average. Like any other car is gonna cost money. I had a Chrysler 300M. That Chrysler actually was a nightmare. I didn't buy the extended warranty, that, and then it transmission of the Chrysler 300M went bad. That was expensive repair. It was like $3,700 to rebuild the Chrysler transmission. That's why. And then when we moved from California to Maryland, the Chrysler radiator blew up. That cost me $1,250. So is VW repair cost expensive? Well, if you go to the dealer, yeah, sure, it's expensive, but they know what they're doing. Since I have the extended warranty, I don't mind. The cost is almost the same like any other car. When you own a car, it costs money, unless you buy it new and it's covered by, you know, their 6 months to, like, what do you call it, bumper to bumper warranty and powertrain warranty, then it should be okay. Do I recommend to buy a used one? Make sure you get an independent, what do you call it, review or survey. So anyway, oh my goodness, I just heard the motorcycle. So yeah, this is how much I'm spending right now. I just spent $1,688.69, but I got a brand new turbo, I got a brand new water pump, and then the brand new speed sensor. And the cool thing about the dealership, I'm not gonna discourage you guys to go to independent shop, but the thing about the dealership, they give me another 12,000 miles warranty. 12 months warranty of their work if the turbo goes bad before, you know, within that 12 months. I can go back and have it checked again, you know. So yeah, their work is what? Has a warranty. So I have another 12 months instead of just 2 years extended warranty. Yeah, the thing was, the safeguard extended warranty cost $1,200. So now they pay $2,631. I get my money back at that point. So I don't have to pay like the whole $4,320.02. So anyway, is VW repair expensive? It can be very expensive, but it's the same like any other car. If you take it to the dealer, I don't care if it's a Toyota, Chrysler, or VW, they're gonna charge the same amount, because the labor, you know, changing the turbo is pain in the neck. You can do it yourself if you want. I don't recommend it if you're not experienced mechanic, because you're gonna have to take the airbox, the bunch of stuff, you know, the intake manifold, and a lot of stuff you have to, you know, pull apart, and then you have to do it yourself. I don't recommend it if you're not experienced. I don't want to do it. It's actually cheaper just to have them do it, you know, to do all the work. So anyway, if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, please click the subscribe button. Again, is the VW Tiguan expensive to repair? Well, it's almost the same like any other cars that I own. They can be very expensive if you don't have the extended warranty, but if you do have it, oh, it's gonna help you a lot. So this car has been running since what? I bought it in 2016, so 2 years, it's not too bad actually for 1,600. I've had worse. Than the Jaguar was the worst one. I spent almost like what, $5,000 in a year, okay, the XJR 100. The Corvette, I spent a lot of money on that one. So yeah, it's almost the same like any other cars. But make sure, if you're planning to buy VW Tiguan used and the salespeople ask you, would you like extended warranty, you say what? Yes. because the extended warranty will cover the repair expenses, and so you won't be surprised. So far, Tiguan is pretty good. Yeah, the turbo may go out on you. Mine finally went out at 57,000 miles. So anyway, love you guys. If you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, please click the subscribe button. Thank you very much. Bye.